Hello friends, I hope you liked my last video that is about performance qualification. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the validation summary report for computerized system. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality, so please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So now let's understand what is validation summary report. So validation summary report is nothing but a report where you capture all the details of performed validation activities, such as the deliverables you prepared and IQ/OQ/PQ satisfactorily performed, and if any discrepancy observed, then the details of discrepancy with the resolution. So such details we need to define in the validation summary report. So the validation summary reports provide an overview of the entire validation project, right? It also ensured that the system was qualified in a compliance with all applicable regulatory requirement and procedures. So now in this slide, we will discuss about the practical approach to write a validation summary report. So the first component of validation summary report is the purpose section, which defines the objectives of all validation approach, right? So in the purpose section, we need to define about the objective, such as this validation summary report is to summarize the activities and deliverables that were identified in validation protocol to validate the system. Now, the second component of validation summary report is the validation overview section. Here we need to describe about the details overview of the system, such as change control details, that is change control number, change control initiation and approval date. Next, we need to describe about the validation protocol details, that is validation protocol number and its execution status details, right? Next, we need to define about the conclusion statement, that is the system was successfully validated and released for routine use in the production environment, right? And next, we need to define about the correctly installed and validated the system. For example, the validation activities demonstrated that the hardware and software are accurately and reliably installed according to its installation requirements, and the system can consistently and reliably produce results which meeting predefined acceptance criteria, thereby which demonstrating that the system is suitable for its intended use, right? Now, the third component of validation summary report is the testing summary. So here we need to define about the IQ testing summary, that is the start date and completion date of installation qualification, and IQ acceptance criteria which meets as per the IQ testing. And also we need to define about the IQ status, that is brief details about the IQ protocol number, status of fail and pass, and if any discrepancy observed, then the reference number of the discrepancy, right? So such things we need to define in the IQ testing summary. Next is OQ testing summary. So here we need to define about the OQ testing summary, that is the start date and completion date of operational qualification, and OQ acceptance criteria which meets as per the OQ testing, right? And apart from this, we also we need to define about the OQ status, that is brief details about the OQ protocol number, status of fail and pass, and if any discrepancy observed, then the reference number of that discrepancy we need to define. Next is PQ testing summary. So here we need to define about the PQ testing summary, that is start date and completion date of performance qualification, and performance qualification acceptance criteria which meets as per the PQ testing. And also we need to define about the PQ status, that is brief details about the PQ protocol number, status of fail and pass, and if any discrepancy observed, then the reference number of the discrepancy, right? So such things we need to define in the PQ testing summary. So here you can see I have given example to provide the relevant details with respect to the IQ testing summary. So there will be the some testing protocol number, right? And there will be the some test ID, like test ID 1, that is verification of hardware and software components are installed, and its status, whether it's pass or fail, and the discrepancy status, like any discrepancy is observed, yes or no, and the that discrepancy number. And in the remark column, if there is any notes, you need to provide any kind of notes or remarks. So you need to define in this remark column. So likewise, you can mention about the OQ protocol testing summary and PQ testing summary report, right? So now the fourth component of validation summary report is the discrepancy and closure status. So in this section, we need to define about the all discrepancy details which was observed during start to end of the validation activities, right? So for example, the details of test ID, details of test step details, discrepancy number, discrepancy details, resolution of that discrepancy, and the closure status of discrepancy. So here we can make a table and provide the relevant details as we discuss in above testing summary, right? So likewise, we can also make a table here and provide the discrepancy and closure status details. So the fifth component of validation summary report is the supporting document. So in this section, we need to define about the supporting documents prepared for the validation activities, right? So for example, details of vendor audit report, that is audit performed date and report approval date. So any observation during the audit, and if so, what was the action taken, and further conclusion statement we need to mention. Next is training records. So here we need to define about the personnel who are involved into the whole validation activities, like the details of creation, execution, review, and approval of validation documents. Those personnel are trained, and also the relevant personnel who are going to use the system in the routine with respect to that relative procedure, that are also trained on that particular system, right? So such a statement we need to mention. Next is standard operating procedure. So here we need to mention the statement for the relevant SOPs for the system were prepared and approved and made effective, right? And also need to provide the details of all relevant SOPs, such as SOP number, its version number, title of SOP, and SOP effective date, right? So such things we need to define. Sixth component of validation summary report is the existing system retirement. So in this section, we need to describe about the change control details for retirement of existing system, if applicable. Otherwise, this section can be write as a not applicable, right? So now the seventh component of the validation summary report is system inventory. So in this section, we need to describe about the system has been added or removed from the inventory list, right? So as per the GMP practice, a inventory list should be maintained for the system available in the department, right? So this list actually need to be updated once the system has been validated. Now, eighth component of validation summary report is summary of validation deliverable. So here the details should be mentioned, that is about the all deliverables name, document number, and approval date, right? Now, the ninth component of validation summary report is conclusion and intended use statement. So here the details should be mentioned about the all qualification activities were performed as per the approved validation protocol and met all the acceptance criteria of validation approach, right? Now the 10th component of validation summary report is system release and intended use statement. So in this section, the statement should be mentioned that after approval of this report, the system can be used in the routine for the intended purpose, right? And also it is certified that system has been successfully validated as per the approved validation protocol and regulatory requirement, and also in-house procedure. So such a statement we need to provide. So friends, this is all about the validation summary report, and in the next video we will discuss about the traceability metrics. I hope this video will help to better understand what is validation summary report, right? So thank you so much.